Hey, good morning, Raincokers. How are we doing this morning?
I know
Chief has gotten you warmed up better than this so far. Good morning, Raincokers.
Good morning, sir.
That's a little better. It sounds real good. Hey, you are one of the top units in the area. You put in a tremendous amount of work for today. This is the day to enjoy the fruits of your labor. I know that Commander Easley and Chief Opperly have worked very hard with your staff to get you guys ready. Just everybody take a nice deep breath right now. You can do that while you're in attention. Nice deep breath.
You okay?
Chief breathing here too. And now exhale. All right. We're going to relax. We're going to have fun today. We got some parents up in the audience right now. But for the rest of it, the ceremony, a great day for them. I'll give the microphone back to Chief. He'll get you ready for how we're going to do the inspection here. And I'm going to talk to the inspectors real quick. But enjoy yourselves today.
Thank you.
once in 100 chance. I think that we're going to have all
Yes.
Which one over there?
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, but we just noticed that.
Just
Send it from the back. Oh, it's a charge.
Thank
and the baby. You can go back to your house. Can your mom keep saying I can go, but I
don't know. No, you can come.
What?
That's the thing.
Back in the memory, it's like 20 minutes.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. That's like
Just a few more minutes, so hang in there. Maybe you'll break your short.
Yeah.
Probably should be a little more centered.
We got that one in the sheet, but I didn't know it was like that.
At this time, our chaplain will come up to the invocation.
I ask that all who would be so inclined to bow their heads would do so and join me in prayer.
Father God, you declared yourself to be the Alpha and the Omega, beginning and end. In our ever-busy lives, it is easy to forget just what that means. Long before any man was here to keep record, you were here. Much the same, long after each and every record ceases to be, you will be here. In every moment of every day, Lord, you are here. Lord, we ask that you make clear to us yourself, the unmoving rock. The things of this world are but fleeting ash. Father, we ask that in your good grace you stand by us. We ask that you stand by the students gathered here today, a most pivotal time in their lives, that through your providence you make clear right from wrong, day from night, truth from falsehood, and you from the world. That you stand by the families gathered here today, be it by blood, faith, or community. These people have dedicated the past 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 years of their lives to these students. We ask that you give them all patience and virtue in this final step and all future endeavors. We ask that you continue to guide all those at RV, teachers, staff, administration, and of course our naval science instructors. You are the teacher of teachers, Lord. We ask that you would continue the work you have already begun. Finally, Lord, we ask that you stand by this nation. We ask that you welcome home all those who have lost their lives in defense of our freedoms. We ask that you give your peace, which is beyond understanding, to our veterans. That you grant steadfast courage to all those serving today. That you proliferate unwavering trust in you for all those going off to serve. That as we go our separate ways, we find peace in you and your word. Lord, you call on us to use the gifts which you have given us. If teaching in our guidance, if serving in our service, if love in our love shown to one another. You proclaim that every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like the shifting shadows. Lord, we ask that you multiply our efforts in your name without fear or concern, that so long as we seek first your kingdom and your glory, tomorrow will worry about itself. For you commanded us, do not be anxious about everything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, to present our requests to you. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. So we now pray in his holy name.
A round of applause for the choir. Great job, choir director. So first of all, welcome to our 50th annual military inspection. It's been 50 years since this unit was established in 1973 by Commander Joe Parks, who's no longer with us, but his memory will always live on through us. We're going to start out, just want to mention a few things before we get started. I'll mention some of the people. First, I want to thank all the parents who've been here. Thank you very much. Round of applause all the parents who've been here today. Of course, I want to thank all the cadets for being here. Great job. You look great today. Excellent job. Superintendent Dr. Violet. Our principal, Mr. Joseph Mark. One of our assistant principals, Mr. Thomas Simonet of Technology. Our director of curriculum, Ms. Tracy Matazzo. Mr. Michael Lamb. We're going to start out by just acknowledging some accomplishments in the past year. We're going to start out by the area manager going to come up and meet some of these people. First of all, we have two people accepted to West Point, David Weiser and Sean Powell, front and center. Woo-hoo! for men. These are full scholarships. Value exceeds over $300,000 each. Congratulations. The next group I'd like to mention are the LAST graduates. We were Captain Eastern Academy in Sail Training. If Kira Marks, Joseph Blazinski, and Bruce Archer would come up front center, meet the area manager. The LAST course is located in Newport, Rhode Island. Cadets get hands-on training in leadership, sailing, everything from how to use a sword to how to do orienteering. Great job. Congratulations. The next group I'd like to bring up are the recent graduates of the COXO-CMC course. It's an online course to prepare our triad, that's our COXO and CMC, for their leadership roles in the unit. If I could have Sean Powell, David Weiser, and Emily Monday, front and center. Next thing I'd like to mention is our five cadets that are earning their drill corps today that are now part of our varsity team. Please come up front and center, Madeline Wilkerson. Serena Rivers. Michael Weiser. Victoria Torres. And Juliana DeLeon. Okay, our next promotions are going to be just a handful of rank promotions. Students take tests in our unit to move up to the next rank. It doesn't count for degree, that's an extra thing they do in order to demonstrate they have the prerequisite knowledge to move up to the next rank. Anyway, the first two getting E2 are Kathleen Nevitt and Shelby Cox. So on the center person. Round of applause again, thank you. Next students taking the rank of Pedagogy Second Class, or E5, Josiah Hardy and Osvaldo Gonzalez. Thank you, gentlemen. Next two students are getting their first class finish to rank for E6, Austin Kerner and Anastasia Curtis.
And we have one Chief Petty Officer selectee, and that is Olivia Oberfrank. Let me tell you, to make Chief Petty Officer is not easy. You have to not only know everything and set a good example every day for your uniform and pride, you also have to demonstrate leadership and the ability to treat others with respect. And she's done all that, so congratulations to Olivia. Okay, the following cadets, please come up front and center, and we'll find out what you're getting in just a second. Morgan Schmidt, Michael Weiser, Serena Framia, David Parkman, Olivia Oberfrank, Brian Lutz, Joshua St. Victor, Lauren Thomas, Syed Bashir, Destiny Williams, Bruce Archer, David Weiser, Sean Powell, Kylie Shenton, Jay Monday, Joseph Kuzinski, Kira Marks, and Julia, you're standing there anyway. All these students are getting the exemplary personal appearance ribbon from the Area 2 Manager, Commander Eric Humphreys. Congratulations. CO, get ready to call away the two demonstrator platoons for the Area 2 Manager.
Thank you.
Platoon commanders. Platoon commanders. Before we do the drill, we do have a couple of announcements that have to be made, so if you could, platoon commanders, get your platoon back in line again very quickly. Just one quick change. Thank you very much. Only take a moment. Thank you very much for the adjustment. Appreciate it. Okay, thank you, Mike.
Thank you very much. So at this time, just for a couple of words, I would like to introduce our principal here at Rancocas Valley, Mr. Joe Martin. Mr. Martin?
Thank you, Dr. Hyland. I will be brief, but I have a very important announcement I'm going to make in a couple of seconds. First, I'd like to say to all the cadets, everyone here, congratulations on another fine, what I'm seeing for drill so far. You are a point of pride, no pun intended, but you are a flagship of our school and a pillar for society in Mount Holly. So thank you for seeing you here. Our alumni, welcome back. Our veterans, thank you. And our former staff members, Commander, Lieutenant Commander, and Chief Bevay, thank you for being here as well. It's always support. Glad to have you both here. With that said, I'd like to make a very special announcement. And before I make that announcement, I need my entourage to come out. So please come out, entourage. Mr. Lamb, can I have you come out with me as well? So look at this crew. Every year, Rancocas Valley partakes in the Governor's Educator of the Year program. Last year's winner, our Teacher of the Year, was French teacher Madame Kim Pope, so she's here to help hand off. We would like to announce the 2023-24 RV Teacher of the Year for the GEOY program, Chief David Aubrey.
Thank you.
Cadets, need you to keep it down so we can get this routine done. Thank you very much. Thank you for your cooperation. Thank you.
Thank you.
Commander John Easley.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for coming out to all of our parents and families supporting the cadets out here today, to our former instructors, any veterans in the audience. Thank you for coming out. We're going to ask you in a few minutes to come up online for the passing review. So thank you all. Thank you for the administrators. I know I think most of them have left, except our department head. Really, without them, you know, we couldn't have the support that we need to help these cadets achieve what they achieve. And the great things that they've done, some just a little small piece of that you've seen on display this morning. But most of all, what I want to do is thank all of you cadets for being here today, for putting on a great display of pride and professionalism, okay, which was evident out there today. A quick word on the inspection. I know some of you were given an outstanding this morning, and we didn't have you up there because we kind of had a pre-planned list, but I promise you, we will go through the list. All of you that got an outstanding from your inspectors, you will receive the award for that. So congratulations for that. You know, Chief and I do kind of ride you a little bit hard as we get ready for this event. Others like it. But really, that's because we want you all to achieve the things that you do and to be able to walk away from this with a sense of pride, a sense of accomplishment. And I think that you'll see that as we move through the year and we go through all of our events, what a great job you've done. So thank you again for that, and keep up the good work. After this, we're gonna turn it over to Chief, and they're gonna have one announcement from our Booster Club president. So thank you.
So, Ann, if you're here, thank you.
Okay, and at this time I'd like to introduce the Area 2 Manager, Commander Eric
D. Humphries.
An extra great honor today to be here when the Teacher of the Year is identified. So once again, let's have a round of applause for the Teacher of the Year. Great to see so many parents out here, all right? Cadets, I know you're all sitting down. A nice round of applause for all your parents that are out here. This program doesn't work. We've got fantastic instructors. We've got a good group of kids here. To make them great, it takes great parents, too. And to see you all out here, I know you all got jobs. It's pretty early on a Thursday morning here, and you've taken time out of your day to be here and support this unit. They've done a great job preparing. This is their day to celebrate. It's an honor for me to be here today. And I thank you once again for the contribution you're making to allow these students to become great students and be the best citizens possible when they graduate. So Chief, let's carry on and get the passing ribbon down.
CEO, keep the banners, get your people ready. Follow the best for you.
Ready for music? Music? Not yet. Who's ready?